And I'm very pleased with what he's done so far. He's taking care of business. He's got the stock market up. He's just trying to do a good job, but he's got a whole lot of opposition out there, mainstream media.
CNN is terrible.
The press are liars. They're terrible people.
The media, look at all those people back there. Scavengers. They're like scavengers.
And the people don't trust the media.
But I think he's doing real good. Trump is popular with the blue-collar people because he doesn't talk down to them. He talks to them at their level, and he doesn't make them feel inferior, even though he's got a gazillion dollars. Because most politicians make it seem like you don't know what's good for yourself, and they know more about how to take care of you than you do yourself. Trump's doing a real good thing with North Korea, because for the last 20, 30 years, talking to them doesn't do any good. So you got to be tough.
Some of the things he ran, I thought were positive. The job platform was important to us. Looking back at countries like France, what was happening there and different parts of Europe with the terrorism and his immigration policy, I thought was good. I didn't want that to happen here in the United States. But now, as time has developed, seeing how he acts, I knew he wasn't going to act quite like the other presidents were going to act. But I just cringe at some of the things he says and some of the things he does, and it almost seems to get worse by the weeks and by the months.
I hate to tell you, Puerto Rico, but you've thrown our budget a little out of whack.
We're also praying for the people of Puerto Rico. We love Puerto Rico.
And now I just can't wait for this 4 years to end. Every day that I wake up and every time he goes somewhere like Puerto Rico or to Vegas or wherever the next event of the world happens and he gets out there, it's like somebody's got to have a microphone in his ear and say something to him so he doesn't open his fat, rich mouth and say the wrong damn thing again. And I voted Democrat probably more often than Republican. But the Democratic Party here in the United States seems like they've lost their way for the working man. And basically, this is a middle-class neighborhood here in the United States. At this point, we're almost wandering around lost, looking for who to vote for at this point. And when the next election comes true to form, it's going to be, again, who can we closely identify with?